We know that transgender and gender diverse people experience great amounts of stigma and marginalization socially, and one of the areas that happens is within healthcare settings. Given all of this, we wanted to understand more about what types of barriers exist to people obtaining gender-affirming medical care. So we asked participants to report on the types of barriers that came up for them when obtaining gender-affirming medical care. Many participants reported that the cost of gender-affirming medical care was often prohibitive, and they oftentimes had trouble with their insurance providing coverage for these services. Another very concerning group of barriers that people talked about, though, was related to education and a lack of education on the part of their providers, and then encountering outright bias and stigma within these healthcare settings. In terms of education, most healthcare providers receive very little education about how to work with trans individuals, and this includes medical healthcare providers as well as mental health care providers. And then in terms of stigma and bias, participants reported a number of damaging experiences, and these ranged from overt acts of bias to more subtle experiences within their care. Many participants in our sample also reported having mental health providers act as gatekeepers in terms of denying them letters of support for their gender affirmation, and that requirement imposed a huge barrier on people being able to obtain the care that was really important for their mental health and well-being. So overall, this work indicates that there are several areas that really need to be improved in order to increase access to gender-affirming medical care for trans folks. So for one, we see that insurance issues really need to be addressed. So we need to ensure that insurance is providing this coverage and providing it in ways that actually enable people to be able to obtain that care. We also see that change really needs to start happening in terms of how providers are trained to work with trans individuals. Other research indicates that medical students continue to have elevated levels of bias towards trans individuals and feel uncomfortable working with trans individuals, and that there continues to be a lack of quality education within medical settings, as well as within mental health training programs. I also think it's really important to acknowledge that this information about bias and stigma within healthcare practices is not new information. Trans people have been talking about these experiences for a really long time now, yet the healthcare field, including medical practices and mental health practices, continue to be really deficient in working with trans individuals. Furthermore, in terms of training and being able to address this, it's really not uncommon for most mental health providers to actually go through their training receiving very little education about how to be an affirming provider and therapist for trans individuals. And that's especially concerning given that medical providers may be asking trans folks to request to obtain these letters of support for their gender affirmation. So we really need to do better both on a professional level as well as within our training programs, so that we can assure that when people are seeking gender-affirming medical care, they're not being marginalized and stigmatized in that process.